Hello my mathematicians, how are you? In this video, we are gonna prove that 1 plus 1 by n raised to the power n as n approaches to infinity is equal to Euler number. So without any further ado, let's get started. Please subscribe to make sure your maths teacher never gets mad at you. Alright, before jumping onto the proof, you need to know the definition of Euler number. So the Euler number is basically a series of 1 by n factorial, where n ranges from 0 to infinity. So this means that this is an infinite series. And here n factorial is the product of natural numbers from 1 to n when n is greater than or equal to 1. And for n equals to 0, 0 factorial is equal to 1. Now for the proof, let Sn be the series of 1 by k factorial, where k ranges from 0 to n and not infinity. So this means that it is a finite series. And as all finite series are less than infinite series, so Sn is less than or equal to e or Euler number. And Sn gets equal to e when n is equal to 0. Now let's open the series Sn. We will need it for comparison later. These steps are pretty self-explanatory. We are just opening the series and also the factorial. Now, one thing that we need to keep in mind that's very important for later use is, for limit n approaches to infinity, Sn gets equal to Euler number. It is so important that I keep it in a golden bar. You will see why in a minute. Alright, now let the series 1 plus 1 by n raised to the power n equals to tn. And this is also a finite series. I'm constantly telling you guys that this series is finite, this is infinite, because we will need it for comparison later. Now, let's break down the series Tn using binomial theorem. So we get this. I don't need to explain it, right? You know the drill. But I have added the binomial expansion for 1 plus x raised to the power n for you to compare the terms of series 1 plus 1 by n raised to the power n with it. Also keep in mind here n is positive, so the expansion is not infinite. Now we just simplified it. I kept the last step in that purple translucent box for you to follow. Here we just simplified it a little bit more. Here you can see that Tn is quite similar to Sn except for this part. Alright, this is quite interesting. So, if we examine this part, we can understand the relation between Sn and Tn, which will help us to move further in the proof. Alright, as we have seen, Tn contains terms like 1 minus 1 by n, 1 minus 2 by n, and so on. So, these terms are always less than 1 because we are subtracting something from 1, even if it is a very small amount. So 1 minus 1 by n is 0 if n is 1, it is 0.5 if n is 2, and you can see the value of 1 minus 1 by n increases as n increases but never gets equal to 1. Same is the case for 1 minus 2 by n, 1 minus 3 by n, and so on. I'm showing you these examples just for your understanding. It's definitely not the part of the actual proof, but it surely helps to understand, and I don't want you guys to memorize this stuff. So what we learned so far is these terms are always less than 1, and we know if we multiply something with a factor that is less than 1, we decrease its value. Like if 2 is multiplied by 0.5, let's say, we get 1. The value of 2 gets decreased. So definitely these terms 1 minus 1 by n, 1 minus 2 by n, and so on, decrease the value of Tn, and we deducted that Tn is less than or equal to Sn. And Tn gets equal to Sn when we take an extremely large value of n that makes 1 by n almost equal to 0. Alright, moving on. Look at this theorem of limit of sequence. If two sequences An and Bn have a relationship that An is less than or equal to Bn for n greater than or equal to capital N, where capital N is fixed, not going to go into the detail of this right now, but what happens after that, that their supremums, when limit is applied, that tends to infinity, have the same relationship between them. So by applying this theorem on Tn and Sn, as we know, Tn is less than or equal to Sn, so this implies their supremums with limit tends to infinity also has the same relationship. Also, we know this from earlier that Sn is less than or equal to Euler number. So this implies that limit n approaches to infinity, supremum of Tn is less than or equal to E, and we call it equation number 1 and put it aside for later use. Now, moving on to the next part of the theorem, if n is greater than or equal to n, then the series Tn becomes this. M is any natural number that can be less than or equal to n. It is just like we opened the series Tn and stopped it at, let's say, 14th term or 15th term and called it T14 or T15. So definitely this new series Tm must be less than Tn, right? Also, Tn is equal to Tm when n gets equal to m. Now, let n approaches to infinity and also taking infimum of Tn, but keeping m fixed, we got this. Guys, does this part remind you of something? Oh, I got it. It is just like the series Sn, except that it has m instead of n, and we know that n is greater than or equal to m. So, we can call this series Sm because it is exactly like Sn, and we got this inequality that Sm is less than or equal to limit n approaches to infinity, infimum of Tn. Now, let's apply the limit at Sm to infinity to get this inequality. Limit m approaches to infinity as m is less than or equal to limit n approaches to infinity, infimum of Tn. Remember that thing we kept in a gold bar? Yeah, this one right here. Limit n approaches to infinity as n is equal to Euler number. So we can deduct that limit m approaches to infinity is also equal to Euler number, because after applying limit tends to infinity, both Sn and Sm become equal. So this implies that Euler number is less than or equal to limit n approaches to infinity, infimum of Tn, and we call it equation number 2. Alright, moving on to the last step of this very lengthy theorem, we compare equation number 1 and 2. Hey, look, by equation number 1, Euler number is greater than or equal to the supremum of Tn, alright? And by equation number 2, we can see it is also less than or equal to the infimum of Tn. How's that possible? So this means that Euler number is basically only equal to limit n approaches to infinity Tn, right? And what is Tn, my friend? We all know. So that's it for the proof. I hope you learned something from today's video. Don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified with my future uploads. I will see you all in my next video. Take care and have a good one. Bye-bye.